Neste segmento vou regressar à cozinha com o chefe David Ribeiro, alguns anos atrás, quando ele me estava a ensinar a cozinhar algumas coisas. Um dos pratos favoritos meus que eu ainda adoro hoje em dia e como sempre que posso, é Seared Tuna, ou seja, um atum muito pouco grelhado, com um sabor fantástico. Vamos ficar aqui com a receita e a apresentação da cozinha com o David Ribeiro.
Today at the Churrascal Market Grill, we're going to prepare tuna.
Yes, we are.
And it looks like a steak.
Yes, it's very similar. It is a tuna steak.
Well, that simplifies things. Tuna steak. So it's about an inch thick, is it?
Yeah, I like to cut it that mm-hmm. thick, just so it won't dry up in the cooking process.
Now, what's the process for the tuna steak?
Very simple. You start out with your onion, mm-hmm. saute that, add your garlic, and chopped onion, of course. Once the two are starting to become slightly golden, add your white wine. Let that reduce. There
I've
you
got
are.
That. I'm in charge of the wine today. And the tomato?
I like to use a little tomato sauce in the rice. You can use fresh tomato. Mm-hmm. It just intensifies a little more when it's a tomato sauce.
Okay.
Add the rice, your tomato sauce or your fresh tomatoes. Let it cook until tender. Salt, pepper, and your rice is done. But you should start with a nice hot pan. Drizzle a little olive oil. You can always see when the pan is hot, because the olive oil starts to run nice and easy. Mm-hmm. Yeah, add your onion.
I like that sound.
The sizzle.
The sizzle.
It's beautiful. Add a little bay leaf. I like the flavor of bay leaf, so I add perhaps more than most people. Mm-hmm. As the onion is starting to become a little bit translucent, as you can see, it's starting to be clear. Mm-hmm. Yeah, add your garlic, and I do like garlic, as you can
so
see.
Do I.
So I add a lot.
That's at least 2 tablespoons.
That's approximately 3 cloves. Now again, you let the garlic come to just a golden stage. You add your wine without it.
Oh, more crackling and sizzling. And that was about a quarter cup of wine or so.
This is about 4 or 5 soup spoons, I would say, tablespoons rather. As it starts to reduce, you see that the wine is evaporating, the fruit of the wine is starting to concentrate in the pan, mm-hmm. and you will start to get your flavors coming together. Mm. I like to add my tomato sauce at right about this time. And again, this depends on how tomatoey you want your rice.
You've added the rice to and the liquid.
The liquid you can use water. You can use, because it's being served with fish, you can use a little bit of a fish stock or mm-hmm. add some a fish bouillon to your water. Mm-hmm. While the rice is cooking, you can just salt your tuna. I like to use sea salt, mm-hmm. a little bit of salt on it, however much you like. And cracked black peppercorns.
So well, you're pressing it down?
I'm just making sure that it stays on the surface. Mm-hmm. You then turn it and do the same thing to the other side.
Okay. And what is this?
This is a relish. Mm-hmm. And it's basically chopped onion. Mm. You put it with chopped tomatoes and red pepper, yellow peppers, chopped
very
as well.
Very finely chopped peppers.
Yes. Add a little parsley. I like to put some black olives into it. I like to also add some chopped capers. Mm-hmm. Little olive oil, salt and pepper, and I like a sprinkle of raspberry vinegar.
And you just...
You mix it all
mix
together,
it all.
And we will use it later.
Okay, so this is ready to also go in a
yes.
pan once our rice is finished.
Once our rice is done, we will go with this, and I'll
okay.
show you how it's done.
Great.
So as the rice is almost coming to being ready, we salt it.
And you use sea salt most of the time or all the time?
I love using sea salt all the time. Mm-hmm. There's a lot more flavor to the salt. And I like to finish the rice with a little parsley.
And you put that right in the center that it looks so appetizing just as it is.
Well, we're going to break it up.
Okay.
It's really meant to be incorporated into the rice.
So that's the last step in the preparation of the rice.
That's what it is.
Is the parsley.
The reason I put the parsley is so that it doesn't overcook and it stays nice and green. So you put it at the end.
Mm-hmm. I'll pass the tuna over to you.
The pan should be very hot.
And it's a cast iron pan.
It's a cast iron pan. You can tell it's hot when the bottom of it starts to turn a little bit white.
Mm.
So you put in just a drop of olive oil.
Ooh, that's
it
hot.
Starts to smoke. And the olive oil is just to stop the pan or to stop the tuna from sticking to the pan. Put your tuna in. By the way, I like to turn off the flame so it doesn't ignite as it would.
I was wondering why you turned it off, but I've noticed you do that before. So that's just
a little caution.
Now, searing just means what? What does searing mean?
Searing is when you're not frying and you're literally just doing the outside of the product.
Mm-hmm.
So in this case, you're just doing the outside, you're toasting the pepper, and you are just browning slightly the outside of the tuna. But as you can see, the tuna remains raw.
Yes, I love that. I like my tuna medium rare.
Or there we
rare.
Are.
Oh, that's great. And it's like a minute.
Well, the pan is really hot. And it should be about medium rare by now.
Well, that's how I like my tuna. Considering that that's for me,
that's how we're going to leave it.
Now, plating this consists of simply, this is a plate for one portion.
Well, this is a plate for you to eat and all your guests.
Okay, I'll have half of the rice.
So we'll put, I like to just put the rice on it.
The rice smells great. It really does.
Thank you.
Mm.
The tuna comes in.
Mm.
You can just
put that on top.
Put your tuna steaks somewhat like that.
Wow. The relish adds taste as well.
A good flavor. The relish kind of finishes the product.
Mm, and it also decorates and finishes it.
Gives it a nice color.
Yes.
But the runoff from the relish is usually good flavor.
Right. It's olive oil, and you say what kind of
olive vinegar? Oil. There's raspberry vinegar.
Raspberry vinegar. Thank you.
And there
vinegar.
It is. My pleasure.
Perfect. Seared tuna with tomato rice.
Seared tuna with a nice tomato rice, yes.
Perfect. Thank you.
Thank you.
Espero que gostaram de ver esta receita simples de o fazer, mas com muito sabor. E o atum é fantástico para as pessoas. I hope you enjoyed it to preparing this simple tuna dish. It's fantastic. Try it at home. It is one of those things that you could try at home for sure. Let's now have more great advice from our sponsors and continue right after this.
Sou Jack Oliveira, Business Manager da Layuna PDC e da Layuna Local 183. Somos gratos pelos gigantes que vieram antes de nós, os que formaram as bases desta grande organização e também os que continuam a construir sobre essas bases hoje. Em nome dos meus executivos, representantes e funcionários, queria desejar aos nossos membros, suas famílias e à comunidade em geral um feliz dia da Ação de Graças.
Excursão a Israel de 2 a 11 de dezembro. No mês do nascimento de Jesus, visite onde ele nasceu, onde ele andou. Visitas guiadas a Tel Aviv, Monte Carmel, Galileu, Jerusalém, Nazaré, Massada, Mar Morto e muito mais. Inclui voo 8 noites de hotel, pequenos almoços, jantares, taxas e entradas turísticas e passeios guiados. Preço por pessoa $4,389. Não perca esta oportunidade de visitar Israel antes do Natal com gente nossa. Lugares limitados. Confirme o seu lugar hoje. Contacte Nellie.